Okay, so we can start now. Hello everyone, welcome you all for NTA lecture number 9. So in the previous lecture we have started the prerequisite required for unit number 1. So in that we have to cover the nodal analysis, super nodal analysis, mesh analysis, and then super mesh analysis. So out of these 4 we have completed the nodal analysis. So nodal analysis we can just revise within a 2 minute. So nodal analysis is what, why it is used, what are the different steps we have to follow, okay, and how to use this nodal analysis to execute or to get the parameters like voltage or current in the circuit. So 2 examples also we have solved. One example we have solved completely, and second example I have given as a homework for you people. So we can what we can do, first I will revise it, and then we can solve one more example, or we can complete that second example and one more example we can take, and then we can take the case of super nodal analysis, and then after that we can understand what is the super nodal analysis. So today will be these points we are going to discuss here. Now if you are observing here, so what are the steps we required? So nodal analysis is called as node voltage method because we are applying the Kirchhoff's current law at the each and every principal node present in the given network. So step number 1 is identify the number of principal nodes which are present in the given network. Principal node means the point in the circuit at which minimum 3 branches should be connected. Minimum 3 branches, that point is called as generally principal node. And choose one of them node as a reference node or ground node, means the common point. Generally, if you are observing the circuit, it is at the bottom level where the common point is there, where the negative of the power supply is connected. That point you have to consider as a ground node. This is the first step. Second step is with respect to that ground node, because ground node is 0 volt, we can consider. With respect to that ground node, you can assign or you can label or you can give the name of voltage variables of that particular nodes. Means suppose except ground node, if 2 more principal nodes are present, then you can give the names like V1, V2, or VA, VB, or VX, VY, like this small letter, capital letter, whatever you can use. Whatever you can give the name, what you want. But with respect to ground, you can assign them the node voltage. That is the second step. And third step is very, very important. You have to apply the Kirchhoff's current law at each and every node. So again, in the third step, we have to follow the rules of KCL. KCL we have to apply in the third step, but there are some rules in the KCL, means how to apply the KCL, that already we have discussed. So KCL, when we are applying, we have to observe how many branches are connected at that point. Then any currents are given in any branch. If given as it is, you can take along with value and direction. If not given, you can assume as an outgoing. And KCL statement is what? The algebraic sum of the current leaving the node is equal to 0. Means leaving current we are taking as a positive, and entering current we are going to take as a negative. So that all are the rules of the KCL. Now once you execute the KCL at first node, then you can apply the KCL at second node, third node, etc. Okay, maximum they can ask for in the examination, though except the ground node, they can ask for 2 principal nodes. Rarely they can ask for 3 principal nodes. Okay, now next step number 4, solve these all equations, because by applying the KCL at each node you can get 1 equation. If you are applying the KCL at second node, you can get 1 more equation. Means how many of unknowns are there, that number of equations you must have to get the values of unknowns. Once you get the known, once you get the node voltages, then you can easily find out the current passing through any element, current passing through any branch, voltage across any element. That you can easily find by using Ohm's law. Okay, if current value is not given, mark as outgoing and take voltage difference divided by resistance. In that way, you can represent that current. So these all are the rules we have discussed in the previous lecture. Still, if anyone having any queries, you can ask freely. Don't hesitate, because concept should be clear. The ultimate aim is what? The concept should be clear so that we can solve thousands of examples. Concept are clear, no, sir. Ek hi example solve karte hai na. Okay. So if anyone having any questions, you can ask. Otherwise, we can go the go to discuss the next point. One like questions. So two examples we have solved in the previous lecture. So in that, a simple example I have taken, and the second example in that I asked the question, find out current passing through 20 ohm resistor. Honestly tell, how many of you solved that example and completed? I told almost to the half part I have completed, and next the hint of next part also I told what the 2 ampere will be the correct answer. So how many of you got that? Anyone? So what is the question here? I will draw the diagram. So this will be the circuit diagram. First of all, I will draw. First example already we discussed. This is the second example. We have completed the 50% and 50% how to solve that hint I have given. Anyone tried and got the answer? So you people are not doing the homework. Whatever the questions, whatever the problems we are solving, that all should be in your notebook. Because when the college will start offline, at any time I will randomly check your notebook. So keep ready your notebook updated always. So this is the question. What is the question? Find out the current passing through this 20 ohm. Okay, by using nodal analysis. So we can start to apply the nodal analysis. This is the first principal node. This is the second, and this is the third common point. Anywhere in this bottom point, there will be the common point that is called as ground. So with respect to this ground, I will assign the node voltage V1 and V2 here. Okay. Now V1 is the first principal node, V2 is the second principal node. So for finding out the current passing through this 20, I need the value of V2. That is your aim. So V1 at node V1, how many branches are connected? 3, first one, second one, and third one here. So no current is given. So mark outgoing. All current I am marking outgoing because no current is given. So apply KCL. We are now using the third step. Apply KCL. In third step, I will make small I because there are the two principal node. Apply KCL at node A or node V1. So assumption is what? V1 is greater than 20. Assume. V1 is greater than 20. V1 is greater than V2. V1 is greater than 0. Okay. V1 is considered as a greater than V2 because then and then this direction will be correct. It may be wrong, but you have to assume. So this branch now, V1 minus 20 divided by 5. All are the outgoing current. That's why all are the positive. V1 minus 20 divided by 5 plus V1 minus 0 divided by 10. That is V1 divided by 10, I will write. Next plus. This plus is due to what? All are the positive term because outgoing current. V1 minus V2 divided by 10. Okay. Now take the LCM. Denominator constant. No denominator constant. 5, 10, 10. What is LCM? LCM is 10. So here multiply with 2. Here multiply with 1. Multiply with 1 means whatever I written in the circle, that you have to multiply with respect to numerator. So 2 into V1 minus 20 plus 1 into V1 plus 1 into V1 minus V2 divided by 10 divided by 10 karayacha, but right hand side is 0. Okay, so multiply with 0, it will give 0. So combine V1 terms and V2 terms, total 4V1 minus V2, and constant is minus 40, goes to the right hand side, becomes plus 40. Always keep in AX1, A1X plus B1X plus or it is equal to C. If two unknowns will be there like this. The constant should be always in the right hand side, because in calculator taking like that only. Okay, this is the first equation. Dot A dot dot. This is the first equation we got. Okay, one equation we got, but two unknowns are there. Means one more equation we needed. So now next step, second step. Actually, we are doing the third step of nodal, but here we have to apply the KCL at two times. One is at V1 and second is at V2. So apply KCL. Apply KCL at node V2. So what will be the assumption here? Anyone can tell what are the assumptions?
V2 is greater than V1.
What are the assumptions?
V2 greater than V1.
Try to understand. Compared to the first one, you can tell for second one.
V2 greater than V1.
Yes. Hello.
V2 is greater than V1.
Yes. So here you have to consider, assume as a V2 is greater than V1. That is for first branch. Second branch, V2 is greater than zero. And for third branch, already current is given. There is no assumption will be required for third branch, because three branches are there here. This you have to consider as outgoing now, because current is not known. This is outgoing already. If you not mark, you can mark. And this is the incoming current, and that value is 4 ampere. This current will flow like this from right to left. Okay, already current is given. So assumption will be only two, that is V2 is greater than V1 for this first branch. For second branch, V2 is greater than zero. Ground picture motor, ground voltage. Okay, so I will write now equation. Out of these three, two are the outgoing, means these two terms becomes positive. And this is the incoming, that's why it is negative. So first of all, V2 minus V1 for this branch, V2 minus V1 divided by 10. This is positive. Next, plus this branch, V2 minus 0 divided by 20. So I will write V2 divided by 20. Next, this is the already current, that's why it is negative, because incoming, minus 4. Is equal to zero. Okay, here nothing is there. Okay, either you can take 4 in the right hand side, or you can take LCM commonly, that is nothing is there means divided by 1 is there. Okay, so denominator is not constant here, so take the LCM. So what is the LCM value here? 20. So 10 into 2 like this, 20 into 1. And here 1 is there means you have to take the 20. So whatever written, you have to multiply with respect to numerator. So 2 into V2 minus V1. Next, 1 into V2, that is a 1 V2. Next, minus as it is, 20 into 4. 20 into 4 will give 80. So minus as it is, divided by 20, but right hand side is 0. 0 is there. So 0 into 20 becomes 0. Okay. Now V1 term first of all you can write, because V1, V2 in this increasing order you can take. So V1 value is 2 into minus V1, that is minus 2 V1. First write V1 term. Next V2, 2 V2 plus V2, that will give the 3 V2. Okay, any constant? Yes, minus 80. Goes to the right hand side, becomes plus 80. So this will be the second equation. So two equations we got. This is the second equation. Take the calculator. Take the calculator and tell me the answers of V1 and V2. Within 1 minute, you can get the answer using calculator. So how to use the calculator to find out V1 and V2 here? Go in a mode, select equation.
So
equation mode madhe jaycha. Then after that, it will ask unknowns 2 or 3. So how many unknowns are there? 2. So you can press 2. And after that, you have to put the coefficient value A1. A1 is 4 here. Then B1, that is a minus 1. Then C1, that is a 40. Next, A2 is equal to minus 2. B2 is equal to 3. And C2 is equal to 80. And then press equal. After pressing equal, you will get value of V1. Once again, press equal, you can get the value of V2. So solving equation 1 and 2 will gives V1 value and V2 value. So put the answer in your chat box. What is the value of V1 and V2? Everyone should carry the calculator along with notebook. For this subject continuously required. Okay, very good. 20 and 40. V1 is 20 and V2 is 40. Very good. So Ashwini Chavan, Aniket Shinde, Priyanka Pawar, Sohel, Ganesh, very good. Asma, Ventesh. Okay, everyone has to try. So V1 is 20 volt. Ekdam correct, and V2 is 40 volt. But what is our question? Find out the current passing through. Find out the current passing through 20 ohm. So that I will solve here. So current passing through 20 ohm, I will give the name as I20. I20 is equal to, if you are observing the circuit diagram here, so that will be V2 minus 0 divided by 20. So this is by Ohm's law, just V2 minus 0 divided by 20. So V2, how much is 40? So 40 divided by 20. Okay, so it will give what? 2 ampere. So I20 is 2 ampere. Everyone understood this example? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, one example we can solve. And then after we can move towards the supernode. Okay. One more typical example we can try to understand. So find out current passing through 10 ohm. Question is question number 3. Find current passing through 10 ohm resistor. Okay, now the circuit diagram I will draw. Okay, now this is the 50 volt. This is the 50 volt. This is the 40 ohm. This is the 50 ohm. This is the 20 ohm. This is the 10 ohm. And this voltage will be 10 volt. So you have to find out the value of this current that is flowing through 10 ohm, I10. This is not given. This is given in the statement only. I have marked here. Okay. So how to start this example now? You have to use the nodal analysis or node analysis. By using node analysis, we can get the answer. Okay, now this common point where the four branches, this is the first, this is second, this is third, this is four, all are meeting at a single point. You can consider here, suppose all are the points are ground points at the bottom. So this is the ground point. So with respect to ground, how many principal nodes are there? This is the first one. This is the second one. Okay, so this is the V1. This is the V2. So can you solve now? Can you solve? I will give the 3 minutes for getting the answer of V1. Or by observing only, tell me what is the V1 value. Here there is no need to apply the KCL at V1. Why and what will be the answer of V1?
50.
There is no need to calculate the value of V1 here. By observing only, you can tell what is the value of V1. Who will tell? You can put in a chat box. The voice is not coming properly. Yes, very good. Shreyas, Ashwini, Aniket, Aishwarya, Asma, Yuvraj, very good. So by observing only, you can easily tell the V1 value is 50 volt. Why? Because across 40 ohm, what is the voltage? That is the V1, because 50 volt voltage source is connected in parallel with this 40. So V1 must be same, that is 50 volt. Very good. Okay. So V1 is the 50 volt, which is across the 40 ohm. So there is no need to apply the KCL to find out the V1 value. Now, if suppose any resistor is there here, then we have to find out. We have to apply the KCL. Now, once you get the V1 value, our task is only to find out the V2. So this is only one principal load we can consider. Okay. Now, once you get the V2, V2 divided by 10, that will give us the current. So V2 we are going to find out. So only one time we have to apply the KCL at V2. So apply KCL at node V2. Many students, what are doing? They are applying the KCL at V1 also. They will get an answer. They will get the answer. But unnecessarily, one more step will get increased. Okay, means apply the KCL at V1. Outgoing current, all these outgoing. Manje kaya karnar de? This they can show outgoing, this they can show outgoing like this. But here there is no resistor, no. So how you can find out the current? Then their mind will become stuck. Then they are not finding any solution further. Are you getting my point? So for that, if your observation is good one, then you can find out the solution, how to go with the next step. So V1, you got the 50 volt. Now V2, you are going to find out. So at V2, how many branches are there? 3. This is the first, this is the second, and this is the third. So nowhere the current value is mentioned. So mention all are the outgoing current. Current, nowhere they have mentioned along with value. So make outgoing current, all are the outgoing current. So I will write now equation. Assumption you can write here. Assume. V2 is greater than V1 manachaka, V2 is greater than 50. V2 is greater than 50 volt. Next, V2 is greater than. Now it is challenging. The 10 volt is how it is connected. See in the circuit diagram. The negative plate is above and positive plate is below. Okay, so this is considered as what? Negative value of voltage. So V2 is greater than minus 10. Why it is minus? Because the negative plate is upper side and positive plate is at lower side. If positive plate is above, then V2 is greater than 10 we are going to consider. But here negative you have to consider because the negative plate is at the top level. Now next, for third branch, V2 is greater than 0. Okay. Now, I will write the equation. V2 minus 50. Don't write V1 again. Okay, one more step, it will increase. V2 minus 50 divided by 50 ohm resistor. Next, plus V2 minus of minus 10. V2 minus, or well, voltage will be that minus 10. That's you can write in a one bracket. Or you can write V2 plus 10. That is also okay. V2 minus of minus 10 divided by 20 ohm resistor. That is this resistor. Next, plus V2. Here nothing is there means ground is there. Okay. So everywhere ground is. V2 minus 0 divided by 10. That is V2 divided by 10 is equal to what? 0. So this is the equation. So LCM is what here? LCM. So LCM is 50 or 100?
100.
You can take as 100.
100.
So 50 in that 100 is there. 20 in that 100 is there. 10, 100 is there. So here multiply with 2. 50 into 2 means 100. 20 into 5. And 10 into 10. So whatever written in the circle, you can multiply with respect to numerator, okay, everywhere. So 2 into V1 minus 50 Okay, next plus 5 into, I will take combinedly now V2 plus 10, and minus minus becomes what? Plus. V2 plus 10 I will take now inside bracket. Next plus 10 into V2 divided by 100 is equal to 0. But when multiply with right hand side and right hand side term is 0, so 0 into 100 becomes 0 only. So combine the V1 terms and V2 terms. 2V2 by either. Now here V2, no V1 term is there. So this is the V2. So combine all V2 terms, 2V2 plus 5V2 plus 10, total
17.
It will become 17. 17V2. So 2 into minus 50 is minus 100. Next 5 into 10 is plus 50. Is equal to what? 0. So 17V2 minus 100 plus 50 means minus 50 goes to the right hand side, becomes plus 50. So what is the value of V2 now? 50 divided by 17. That will be, you can cross check, 2.94.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
V2, we got 2.94 volt. Okay, so once you get the value of V2, you can easily get the value of current passing through 10 ohm. So I10 now, I10 is equal to V2 minus 0 divided by 10. So V2 is nothing but 2.94 divided by 10. So answer will be 0.294 ampere. Or you can write like this, 294 milliampere. Both are same. 0.294 ampere or 294 milliampere. Milli means 10 raised to minus 3. So everyone understood this third example?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Or no?
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So in the chat box, you can put yes or no. Okay, so there are the number of problems we have to solve, but now we can focus on supernode analysis. So supernode analysis we can try to understand, and why there is a need of supernode analysis, that first I will tell, and then we can move towards this supernode analysis. So for that purpose, I have to use one example I can show, so that why we have to learn this supernode analysis, that reason we can understand first of all, and then we will see what is the supernode analysis, and based on that we can solve that example. So here the question is, find current find current passing through 5 ohm resistor. Okay, so the diagram I will draw. So this is the current source, 10 ampere. So this is the 3 ohm. So this will be the 2 ohm. This is the voltage source that will be 20 volt. And this is the 2 ohm. This will be the 5 ohm through which we are going to find out the current. And this is the voltage 10 volt. We are finding this current I5. Okay. So by observing the circuit, we can select the nodal analysis. Okay, we can start. So nodal analysis, suppose we are using. Node analysis, suppose I have selected. Okay, now according to the first step, identify the number of principal nodes present in the given network. So this common point where the negative of the supply is connected or the based on this current source, we can consider this as a common point. That is the zero volt, that is the ground. Everywhere it is present, okay? Everywhere. Now next, with respect to this ground, how many principal nodes are present, you can identify. So this is the first one. Because three branches are connected, 10 ampere current source, 3 ampere, 3 ohm and 2 ohm. So this is the second one. And this will be the third one. Here it is second because three branches are connected here. Here also third one because three branches are connected. So I will assign now V1, V2 and V3. Okay, means two steps we have covered. Third step is what? We have to apply the KCL at each and every node. We have to apply the KCL at each and every node. So if you are applying the KCL at V1, if you are applying the KCL at V1, we are not facing any problem because this current is already given, that is incoming. This is 10 ampere as it is, you can take along with direction. Current so mark as outgoing. Here also current is not given, so mark as outgoing. So I will write minus 10 because it is incoming. Next, V1 divided by 3. Next, plus V1 minus V2. Divided by 2 ohm is equal to what? 0. So nothing is there means 1 is there. So take the LCM of 6. 6 is the LCM. So multiply with 6. Multiply with 2 here. Multiply here with 3. Okay. So 6 into minus 10. Minus 10, that is the minus 60, goes to the right hand side, becomes plus 60, that we can take. Minus 60. Next, 2 into V1, that is 2V1. Next, 3 into V1 minus V2. V1 minus V2 is equal to what? 0. Okay. Now solve this 2V1 and plus 3V1. That will give what? 5V1. Next, V2 is 3 into minus V2 is minus 3V2. So V3 is not mentioned. V3 is not present. So if not, you can take as like this 0 into V3. If not, any variable is not present in equation, you can take 0 into that variable. That is 0 into V3 is equal to 60. So this is what the equation number 1. three unknowns will be there, so we need three equations. So this is equation number one. Okay, there is no problem for applying the KCL at V1. KCL at node V1. There is no problem. Now, if you want to apply the KCL at node V2, so we can take second one. Apply KCL at node V2. So what is the problem here to apply the KCL at V2? What will be the problem you are facing? See here, if you want to apply the KCL at node V2, here is no problem to find out the current mark as outgoing, V2 minus V1 divided by 2, no problem to find out this current. Here also for this branch, there is no problem to find out. Okay, one more resistor value is remaining here. So this is 1 ohm. Now, here there is a no problem for getting the current and mark as outgoing, V2 minus 0 divided by 1. But what is this current? If you are marking outgoing, whether it is incoming, and what will be the value of this current? Minus. Because there is no resistor present here, only a voltage source is connected. So when between two principal nodes, V2 and V3, or any between any two nodes, when it is connected by just a voltage source, then it is difficult to find out the current. जर फक्त दोनच ऍडजस्टंट नोड जर फक्त व्होल्टेज सोर्सने कनेक्ट केला असेल विदाउट एनी रेजिस्टर और विदाउट एनी लिनियर कंपोनेंट दॅट इज रेजिस्टर कॅपॅसिटर इंडक्टर इफ नॉट प्रेझेंट इन दॅट ब्रांच देन इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू फाइंड आउट दिस करंट सो इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू फाइंड आउट द करंट हाऊ यू कॅन अप्लाय द केसीएल आर गेटिंग माय पॉइंट सिमिलरली For this branch, you can easily find out the current because along with this voltage source, the resistor will be there. Means V3 is greater than 10, you can assume. V3 minus 10 divided by 5 ke liye ha current deal. For this branch also, you can find out the current. Okay, but it is difficult to find out this current. So how you can assume V3 is greater than V2 or V2 is greater than V3? Obviously, by observing this sign, you can say that V2 is greater than V3. But what will be the current value? How you can express for finding out current? What you needed? Voltage difference divided by resistor, but nowhere resistor is present here, only voltage source is there. So how to solve such an example? This problem we are facing in some problems, in some numerical example when you are using the nodal analysis. So such a example, such a problem we can solve by using supernode analysis. So supernode analysis is one of the case of this nodal analysis. Okay, so this we have to observe, this we have to understand when we are facing certain problems. So what is the certain problems? When two adjacent nodes are connected by a single voltage source, then it will forms a supernode. Okay, so I will show that. Where is the supernodes? So supernode is formed by this area. So this is called as what? Supernode. This is called as what? Supernode. Okay, the supernode means it consisting of two principal nodes V2 and V3, and which is connected by a single voltage source. So this part in the circuit, that is from V2 to V3, this part is considered as a super node. Are you getting my point? So the node which is a not a part of super node, म्हणजे असा node तुम्हाला select करायचा जो जो super node चा part नाही आहे, त्या ठिकाणी तुम्ही पहिला KCL apply करून घ्या. So apply the KCL at a node which is a not a part of super node. So you can get this equation. So I have given already this as equation number 1. Now next, it is difficult to apply the KCL at node V2 as well as V3. Okay, it is difficult to apply the KCL at node V2 and V3 because of super node. So what you have to do now, this branch you have to leave. Don't consider this branch. A branch to me consider karu naka. Okay, this branch which is connected by V2 and V3, forget about that. And for remaining branch, for remaining branches at V2 as well as at V3, you can apply the KCL. Okay, so what you have to do, this you have to mark as outgoing current. Okay, and this also you have to mark as outgoing current. Next, this is the outgoing current and this is the outgoing current. So combinedly you have to apply combinedly, apply KCL. I will write apply KCL combinedly apply KCL combinedly at node V2 and V3. So when you are applying combinedly the KCL at node and V2 and V3 means you have to leave this super node part. You have to leave this super node part. So I will write in a bracket, just like except super node part. Except super node part. Okay, except super node part, you can apply the KCL. So I will write how many branches are now there combinedly. This is the first, this is the second, this is the third branch, and this is the fourth. So four term will come. So V2 minus V1 divided by that 2 ohm resistor. V2 minus V1 divided by 2. Okay, next. V2 minus 0 divided by this one. All are the outgoing I have shown because nowhere current is mentioned. V2 divided by 1. Next plus this branch you can consider now. V3 minus 10 divided by 5. V3 minus 10 divided by 5. And lastly plus V3 minus 0 because this is ground is here. V3 minus 0 divided by 2. It is equal to 0. So how many terms are there in the equation? First, second, third, fourth, because four branches are there combinedly. So in that first two, V2, V1 will come. Here V3 will come. So solve this equation. You can get one equation by taking LCM. LCM is what? 10. Okay, LCM is 10. You can get one equation. So second equation you can get. First equation already we got here. And second equation you can get here. But three unknowns are there. V1, V2, V3, and only we have two equations. Are you getting my point? Only we have two equations. So where we can get the third equation? Kutun milanar apun third equation? Yes? From where we can get the third equation? Anyone? You can put in chat box. From where we can get the third equation? Where we can get the third equation? See, we have left this part. Okay. So we have left this part. So which is the left part? Super node. So from that part, we have to get the third equation. Okay. So if you are observing this supernode part, then voltage is nothing but potential difference between two points. So V2 minus V3 means V2 is at positive side, minus is at V3 side. That's why V2 minus V3 divide is equal to 20. So this equation we can get from the supernode. Okay, because here in this second part, we have left except supernode only. So supernode part we have to consider in the third. So from the supernode part, if you are observing, this 20 volt voltage source is nothing but V2 minus V3 is equal to 20. So here V1 is missing. So take 0 into V1, next plus V2, next minus V3 is equal to 0. So this is the third equation. So total we have, so this will be the third. So total we have three equations. This is the first. You can solve this. You can get the second equation. And here is the third equation. So solve these three equations by taking calculator. You can get the answer of V1, V2, V3. So this is the what? Supernode analysis. Okay. This is what? The supernode analysis. So this problem we can explain further. So just remember. Now what we can do here. So quickly we can discuss this supernode analysis. So whatever we have done, just we have to see in a procedure way. So supernode analysis is the special case of nodal analysis. So first two steps are same. Identify the number of principal nodes. Means first you can start from the nodal analysis only. Identify the principal nodes and choose one of them as a reference node, that is the ground. Second step, assign the node voltage with respect to ground, that is V1, V2, V3 like this. Next step three is what? Apply the KCL at the principal node, which is not a part of super node. This is very important statement. In the third step, what we are doing, apply KCL at the principal node, which is not a part of super node. Means in the previous example, the V1, the node V1 is the example, which is a not part of a super node analysis. Now next we can get one equation. After that, in the step number four, apply the KCL combinedly. Apply the KCL combinedly at the nodes which are affected by supernode. Apply the KCL combinedly at the nodes which are affected by supernode or which are the part of supernode. Combinedly you can apply the KCL. So how we have to apply? Except that principle, except that supernode part, for remaining branch, you can apply the KCL combinedly and you can get the second equation. And last one more equation you can get, that is the, you can get that equation from supernode part. Okay, from the supernode part, you can get that equation. Just like I have shown, V2 minus V3 is equal to 20. Okay, so from that part, you can get the one more equation. And finally, in the last step, you have to solve all these equations and you can get the answer of node voltages V1, V2, V3, etc. So these are the steps we have to follow in the supernode. So what is the new things here? We cannot apply the KCL at the supernode directly. So for that purpose, we have to apply the KCL at the node, which is not a part of supernode. Then second one, apply the KCL combinedly at the nodes which are affected by supernode. And next, get the equation by observation from the supernode. These are the only new things added in the supernode analysis. So in the next lecture, whatever the problem we have discussed previously, that problem once again we can solve and we can understand, try to understand the supernode analysis. And once we can complete, one more problem we can solve on the supernode analysis. And after that, we can start the mesh analysis. So if anyone having any questions, you can ask. Otherwise, we can stop for today. Any questions? Okay. So thank you, everyone. You can leave now this group.